The prophetic perspective teaches that these seven churches represent seven church ages that have been in the earth. You could look at the apostolic age as the church of Ephesus. Ephesus was where they tested false apostles and found them to be false. Ephesus was where they persevered and didn't deny the name of the Lord. You could look at the second church, Smyrna, as the age of persecution, where the church endured gross persecution under the Roman Empire, under emperors like Nero and Hadrian and others that were just totally against the body of Christ and against the church, fed them to lions, them in two, put them in gladiatorial arenas, you know, several hundred years of persecution, 10 emperors and 10 waves of persecution that came against the church. And you can look at that as Smyrna. And then you can look at the third age as the political age. The political age also linked with the occult, and that's the church of Pergamum, where John the Revelator said at Pergamum was where Satan's throne was. There's a few reasons that probably he said that, and they're actually very relevant for us today. There's three primary reasons why John would have said that Pergamum was where the throne of Satan was. The first one was that was where the altar of Zeus was, a huge altar, about 100 feet in width, about 60 feet in diameter, and about 60 feet deep. It sunk into the earth. This altar was an altar where all kinds of abominations were done, and all kinds of abominations were depicted even on the altar. That altar, interestingly enough, was moved piece by piece from modern-day Turkey to Berlin, Germany. And from Berlin, Germany, that altar was pulled upon for revelation and inspiration by the Nazis as they created their great amphitheater, their great, you know, stage where Hitler would come in to that stage and sway the masses, and he would almost depict himself sort of like a god of old that was rising up with the occult power that he was so interested in. That's the first reason, that altar. The second reason is that the temple of the snake god was in that region also. And people would come to that region from all over, and they would make pilgrimage to go to that temple of Asclepion, I think is how you say it, and they would sleep in the temple of the snake god overnight, and they believed that if a snake passed by you, because there were loose snakes in that temple, that you would be healed if a snake passed by you, right? And then the third reason was because at that time, in Roman culture, that you had to burn incense to Augustus Caesar. And if you didn't burn incense to Augustus Caesar and essentially venerate him like a god, then you were cast out. You were a second-class citizen in Roman culture at that time. And if you look at these three things where Satan's throne dwelled, you look at it and you can identify the occult with Zeus's altar, you can identify the political spirit burning incense to Augustus, and you can identify a false healing. I'd call it pharmacia or pharmakia, and there is all kinds of things connected to that also in the occult. And so we see that those things become very relevant for us today.